Alright, yeah, I've really reduced a lot of my videos here. I'm down to 3, 3:40 or 20 or whatever. yeah, I can't handle these large uploads any longer. But so I'm headed through, and I'm like looking at some images, and I'm like, well, looking at this yellow flower, and I took a picture of it, and I'm like, well, what was the deal that it had to be so outlandish? You know, it's just a simple yellow, little yellow flower, a daisy. And all the others are also daisies, and they all look alike. They're all the same, you know, genetic material. They're all the same code, you know, that makes them that way. And yet, there was a moment between me as the photographer and the flower itself, that attraction that, yes, you're gonna take a picture of me. I've actually situated, you know, in the flower's construction, you know, I've actually situated myself here to be photographed. I have put myself in the best area of sunlight and day, cloud shadows, everything. So I'm the most attractive out of all the other flowers, even though we all look exactly alike. For some reason, that little tiny, now it is, it's just a tiny little yellow daisy, has decided to have a magnitude self, an absolute magnitude self over all the others. And it has gained, we will call it a celebrity. It has gained a celebrity, where the others are just, they're just gone into the background. It is the celebrity now. So somewhere in the code, in the mechanism of plants, and I'm not going to say humans, but somewhere in, because that little flower could be doing that, exactly that attraction mechanism, even throwing himself at the mercy of a dog that could walk by and eat it. Because I've had dogs before, they've grabbed the heads off of flowers. Being right there at that moment, you know, is a risk to be out there. The drama on display, the most wanted, in the best light, in the absolute on stage, on the on stage moment. So it's a very, very, like, it's a pivotal deduction right now, when you are looking at a flower itself. Making the choice mechanism, making that choice. Hey, I'm gonna grow where I'm actually surrounded or I'm attracted to others that are not other yellow daisies. I'm gonna grow there. I'm gonna take my chances. I'm gonna be photographed. Not only am I going to be photographed, I'm going to take my chances and possibly be eaten by a dog. Or worse, you know, on the outer periphery. You bet. You bet. Now why is that going on? And we're talking an average event, an average flower. They're all the same, they're all the same. You look at them at the store, and you go and you're like, well, yeah, there's a bag of bulbs, or yeah, there's a bag of seeds. They're all the same. They're all going to grow exactly the same. But they don't. They're alive. They're absolutely alive. They do not grow exactly the same. They may have the constructionism right there, that they have to have certain sunlight, they have to have certain fertilizer to grow, you know, prodigiously. However, when you really, really look at it, why? Why does one beckon itself out there to the stage and take the risk? just like an actor or an actress, a dancer or a singer. They go out there to the stage and they take the risk of, the flogging, of the tomato event or the applause. That little flower is doing that. It could have cringed in the background and said, oh no, I'm going to head this way, that's fine. I'm going to be this little yellow flower over here. But no, the exact same genetic code says, uh-uh. I'm going to have a different personality and put myself right there on the path. I'm going to take my chances, and a photographer is going to film me or take a beautiful photo. So anyway, that's just a little bit of, I don't know, I'm harping about my yogi a lot lately, and I've forgotten it, and anyway. So I'll put a little image of my little yellow flower that found applause. Okay?